Here, the beast will be imprisoned.
Typhon. Typhon! Typhon!
Welcome back, everyone. It is Amelia. I hope you are fine. Blood of Zeus Season 2 brings back Typhon and establishes him as one of the show's most powerful monsters. Building off the massive battles at the end of Season 1, the Pantheon spends much of Season 2 dealing with heroic figures like Heron and his allies, as well as the machinations of Hades and Persephone to claim the powerful Eleusinian Stone. The Netflix animated series is inspired by Greek mythology and uses those ancient stories as a springboard for an explosive drama full of intrigue, backstabbing, and conflict. Through the primordial deity Gaia, Blood of Zeus gods are confronted with their mistakes but can't seem to escape a cycle of violence and betrayal. This all builds to the ending of Blood of Zeus Season 2, which sets the stage for Typhon to become the show's most dangerous threat. This is exactly what happens at the end of the season, when Gaia witnesses Hades killing the heroic Heron to claim the stone. Deciding this act is a step too far, Gaia turns against the Pantheon and summons Typhon to retake the world. This shatters the stone and sets up the return of the Titans led by Typhon. Typhon's status in Blood of Zeus suggests he'll be an overwhelming threat in Season 3, befitting the power levels of the other gods. Typhon's status as a massive threat to the Pantheon is reflective of the character's mythological origins. In the original Greek mythology that inspired Blood of Zeus, Typhon was the son of Gaia and Tartarus, making him the child of both the earth and the underworld. The monstrous entity became a major progenitor of monsters from across mythology, siring several children with the monstrous half-woman Echidna. In ancient mythology, Typhon's most important role was as one of Zeus' greatest challenges when ascending to the throne of Olympus. In most versions of the story, Zeus defeated Typhon alone with the use of his thunderbolt. In others, Zeus is actually almost beaten but receives crucial aid from gods like Hermes and figures like Pan. Even when compared to the Titans, Typhon was a powerful foe, which makes his elevation as a massive threat to the Pantheon in Blood of Zeus a perfect turn for the character. Typhon's return in Blood of Zeus sets up an explosive and action-packed Season 3. Before the events of the series, the entire United Pantheon was able to work together to defeat Typhon. However, the Pantheon has become increasingly divided, especially across Season 2 as different factions within the group competed and fought for power. Zeus is also dead, lost to the underworld after the events of the previous season. This means Typhon's return could force the remaining gods to unite or further splinter them apart in their panic to contend with the threat of Typhon's return. Season 3 will also have to deal with the death of Heron and what it means for the Pantheon. This could be the opening to push his dangerous brother Seraphim into a more overt heroic role, taking charge in the battle against Typhon. It could also force the heroes to find a means of bringing figures like Heron and Zeus back to the land of the living. Blood of Zeus is said to be an explosive battle for the future of the gods and humanity alike, as Typhon's victory over the Pantheon could rewrite the power structure of all existence. Give me some ideas related to my video in comments on below if you like this video, and subs for more upcoming videos.